In this video, we discuss the equilibrium constant for the dissociation of Pcl5. Equilibrium constants are Kc and Kp. Kc is the equilibrium constant in terms of concentration. Kp is the equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressure. So we have taken a phosphorus pentachloride. So phosphorus pentachloride dissociates to form phosphorus trichloride and chlorine gas. All reactants and the products are in the gaseous state. So this is an example of a homogeneous equilibrium. So here it is given A moles of PCl5 is taken in a vessel of volume V. X moles of PCl5 dissociated to form X moles of PCl3 and X moles of Cl2. So we tabulate the data in the tabular column. Here PCl5, PCl3, Cl2. So initial number of moles taken. So here it is given A moles of PCl5 is taken. So the initial number of moles of PCl5 is A. In beginning we don't have PCl3 and Cl2. Then next, now X moles of PCl5 dissociated. So number of moles dissociated will be equal to X, because X moles of PCl5 dissociated. We cannot predict how much moles of PCl3 and Cl2 are there. At equilibrium, the number of moles. To find out this one, you take the initial moles as A. From A, X moles dissociated. So what is left at equilibrium will be A minus X. So A minus X moles of PCl5 is left. Then X moles of PCl3 and X moles of Cl2. So this X you have to multiply with the stoichiometric coefficients. Here in the equation, here it is stoichiometric coefficients of PCl3 is 1 and Cl2 is 1. Therefore, we can write X and X. Then molar concentration is nothing but number of moles divided by volume. So molar concentration is nothing but the equilibrium concentration. So at equilibrium, the number of moles it is given for PCl5 A minus X. So A minus X divided by the volume of the vessel. For PCl3, X is the number of moles at equilibrium. So, X by volume of the vessel V. For Cl2, X divided by the volume of the vessel V. Then, you take the equation. PCl5 dissociates to form PCl3 and Cl2. Apply the law of mass action for this equation. So, when you write Kc, this derivation of this one we have discussed in the first video. Here for this particular equation we can write Kc. Kc is equal to the products in the numerator. So products are PCl3 and Cl2. So the concentration of PCl3, concentration of Cl2 divided by the concentration of the reactant. Reactant here is PCl5. So the concentration of the phosphorus pentachloride. So that will be equal to, in the previous video we have written PCl3 X by V molar concentration, Cl2 X by V, and PCl5 A minus X by V. So that you have to substitute here. So here you take X by V into X by V divided by A minus X by V. So that will be equal to 1V cancel, X squared divided by A minus XV. So this is the equilibrium constant in terms of concentration. So Kc will be equal to, here it is given, Kc is equal to X squared divided by A minus X into V. Now to calculate Kp, equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressure, we need the relationship between Kp and Kc. So in the first video I have discussed how to derive the relationship between Kp and Kc. So Kp is equal to Kc into RT power delta Ng, where Kp is the equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressure, Kc is the equilibrium constant in terms of concentration, R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, where delta Ng. Delta Ng is nothing but equal to number of stoichiometry moles of the gaseous products minus number of stoichiometry moles of the gaseous reactants. That is, Np is the stoichiometry moles of the gaseous products, Nr is the number of moles of the gaseous reactant. So for this equation you have to find out. So when you write PCl5 dissociates to form PCl3 and Cl2, when you calculate delta Ng, delta Ng will be equal to product. Here 1 mole of one stoichiometric coefficient of PCl3 is 1, Cl2 is 1. So totally for the product side 2. So 2 minus the reactant side you have 1. So that is the difference will be equal to 1. That you have to substitute in the relation. So when you substitute, you will be getting Kp is equal to Kc into Rt to the power 1. But the RT you should write in the form of pressure and volume. So you take an ideal gas equation. The ideal gas equation is PV is equal to nRT. Now you have to replace RT. Therefore you can write RT is equal to PV by N. So we bring this N to this side. So you will be getting RT. RT is equal to PV by N. Now you substitute in the in this equation, that is Kp is equal to Kc into Rt. Instead of Kc, you write the expression for Kc. Rt you substitute as Pv by N. So you will be getting Kp is equal to x square divided by A minus x into V. This is the expression for Kc into Pv by N. That is for Rt. So where what is N? N is the total number of moles at equilibrium. So how to replace this N? You have to take at the equilibrium, we have discussed the number of moles. For PCl5, A minus X. For PCl3, X. Cl2, X. We have written the tabular column. That you have to take and find out. So A minus X plus X plus X. Because total number of moles, you have to add everything. So when you add, you will be getting A plus X. So replace this N by A plus X. So you will be getting X square divided by A minus X into V into PV divided by A plus X. So that will be equal to X square into P, because V and V cancel, P divided by A minus X into A plus X. So this is the expression for Kp and this is the expression for Kc for the dissociation of PCl5. So we have derived the Kc and Kp for the dissociation of PCl5. Next, we will go to the degree of dissociation. So what is degree of dissociation? The degree of dissociation is the fraction of the reactant consumed out of one mole. So how much of the reactant is consumed out of one mole? That will give the degree of dissociation. Suppose if you take one mole, out of one mole, 0.2 mole is consumed. Then 0.2 is the degree of dissociation. So degree of dissociation is represented by the letter alpha. Its value lies between 0 and 1. So if it is 0, then we can say that only the reactant is present, no product, no reactant has been consumed. If the value in between, so it will be from 0 to 1, it should not have a negative value. It may be 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 or 0.001 likewise. But it cannot be negative, only positive value. If it is 1, that means all the reactant has been consumed. So only product will be present. So we can write the degree of dissociation as alpha is equal to number of moles of reactant consumed. How much moles of reactant consumed divided by number of initial number of moles taken. So if you have all number of moles reactant consumed, if it is equal to 1, then initial number of moles taken will be also equal to 1, then alpha is equal to 1. So when alpha is equal to 1, all the reactant has been consumed and it is converted into product. So in this case, in the case of PCl5, how to find out alpha? So we take the tabular column. So here it is given number of moles at equilibrium. It is given as A minus X, X, X. So only for PCl5 we are going to find out. So alpha is equal to number of moles of reactant consumed divided by initial number of moles taken. That is equal to, from here only X moles is consumed. So X you write divided by total initial number of moles taken is equal to A. So that is equal to A. So alpha is equal to nothing but X by A. So thank you for watching this video.